Okay, so I had a few problems with the guitar, the bass recently, like it's not cutting out, it is cutting out rather. So let's see what this is. Cable tester, what brand is it? Good question. Features, it's nameless. SoundLab. SoundLab Universal Cable Tester T1 type, whatever that means. So I'm not quite exactly sure what it was. Let me sit down a second, get this thing out. So it comes in a bit of plastic, a bit of wrap, and let's see what's in it. Okay, it's quite hefty, first of all. It's got a bit of heft to it. Okay, looks like a battery goes in here by the looks of it. Let me see, let me pause. Yeah, you just lift that little bit up, like it says lift or withdraw, it comes out, and now we've got space for a battery, and it's got a picture of it, but plus is on the left. Okay, let's see if I've got one of these. Okay, apparently I do. I don't know if it's going to work. Plus is on the left. There we are. This should go back into its Thunderbird 2 dock. For those of you old enough to remember that. Is that it? Hang on, pause. Okay, so just as we had to push down and up to get it out, once you push it in, it bounces out again until you push it down. Yeah, so that's something to know. Let's have a look. What can it do? Let me find a cable, if I can find the blue one, hang on. Okay, so my blue jack that didn't like to be working, or sometimes is cutting out, but I suspect it's some other cable problem, maybe in the guitar itself. Let's just plug that in there, like so. Ooh, little lights have come on, hang on. So what does this mean? It's currently at the bottom one, and it says 1-1. So maybe that means that 3 isn't quite connected. Let's read the manual. I think you're supposed to move this along like this and it can fold. Oh no, look, look. Okay. All that means at this point is that 1 is connected to 1, but it's also connected to 3. I suppose tip, ring, sleeve. 2 is connected to 2, so there's no short there. And 2 is connected. Oh, okay, that's interesting. Yeah, so maybe that does show there's a problem with this cable. But before I get too excited, because I haven't read the manual, let me just unplug this cable and put one in that I'm absolutely positive is working. And let's see if that works. Okay, so it's the same design. It's just red. Oh, didn't like that, did it? Sorry, let me just pause and plug that in. Okay, it's doing a similar thing where 1 is connected to 3. Yeah, 1-1-3. So last time we got 2-2 together, didn't we? See what happens there. Yep, and then we got 2-3, didn't we? That's that way round. They're like that, they're like that. Okay, let's do the blue one again. So it's a pattern that sort of swaps. It might be something to do with the way that these particular cables are made. I mean, maybe they're just made wrong. I've been using them for a while. No bull whatever, and they normally say they'll give you the money back if they break. Okay. Yeah, so we had that pattern. So when we go to 3, we'll get the opposite pattern. The air will go in the other way, yeah? We don't. Interesting. So these cables are different. I have to investigate that. 2 like that. So the other one I got like an L like that. So I will take this apart and have a look. But anyway, so far the basic thing seems quite good. I only ever use jack. What else do I use? I don't use speak on at the minute, but they do use it at the church. I use 5 pinned in. That should be there somewhere. XLR I use. In there, let's have a look on the side, see what's on it. Yeah, I use those ones. My amps don't use that, but I might do that. IC5, I guess that can do MIDI, because I suppose when you plug it in and there's less pins, it would just do the 5 at the top. What is that one? Phono. Yeah, I don't really use that much these days. TRS, yeah, all the time. What's at the top here? Speak on. Actually, I thought it had USB stuff in it. I'll have to look to make certain that I've ordered the right one. Or, indeed, they've sent the right one. But this one doesn't do... This one doesn't do Ethernet or anything like that. So I'm going to look back to see what I ordered, because maybe this isn't what I was expecting. In which case, it's going back with evidence that this isn't what I was expecting. But look, there's a picture there of a... What? Yeah, this is different, look. That's got a picture of RJ45. That doesn't have a picture of RJ45. So maybe it's one of these things where they use a generic picture and then send you the wrong thing. But this is RG45. How the hell is it supposed to check that if there isn't a hole for it? Yeah, I think I'm going to have a word with the person that sold me and say, dude, I think you sent me the wrong one, or it's in the wrong bloody box, yeah? Anyway, thank you for watching. I thought I was getting the Ethernet tester because we have these cables for the Behringer desks, yeah, and I wanted to check the Ethernet. So I think it's got to go back. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.